Hi there, this is Ashwin again. How is it going? Welcome back to my series of tutorials on OpenCV3 and Python 3. In the last tutorial, we saw how to compute the histograms of grayscale as well as color images using matplotlib. We used plt.hist function and img.ravel function for accomplishing the same stuff. We also saw how to use plt.xlim to limit the values that we are displaying on x-axis. So in this tutorial, we are going to have a look at how to use NumPy to compute the grayscale as well as color histograms. So we have already learned the concept of histogram, so I don't think that it is necessary for us to repeat the concept of histogram only for the sake of this video. So in case you are interested in learning what histogram is, go ahead and check my earlier video in the same series and you will be able to understand what histogram is and what frequency tables are. So I have already written the program and tested it in order to save the hassle and time while creating this video. And there is nothing much new. There are not many notable differences between how we create the histogram using matplotlib and using NumPy. Okay, so let's have a look at how we can create the histogram using NumPy. So in matplotlib, we have the function known as plt.hist. So this plt.hist automatically calculates as well as displays the histogram. In NumPy, we have to calculate the histogram first, and then that histogram is stored in a list. So you can compute the histogram using np.histogram function, and the parameters that we are, or the arguments that we are providing to this function are same as plt.hist. Okay, so first of all, we need to provide it the flattened image, that is img.ravel, and then we need to provide it the number of bins or the number of intervals. It is definitely going to be 256 because every channel is a 8-bit channel for anything, for even for grayscale image as well as color images. The plane will be 8-bit, and 8-bit corresponds to 256 different values from 0 to 255, and then we need to provide the range of values. Then we are setting the limit of x-axis to 255, and then we are setting the limit of y-axis to 3000. Okay. And then we are using a plt's plot function to draw the histogram. So first of all, we will execute the code which is calculating the histogram using matplotlib, that is plt.hist, and let's observe the result. So this is the result using plt.hist. Similarly, if you use np.histogram to calculate the histogram of the same image, you will get similar result or the same result. See, the result is exactly the same. The only thing is that it is not a bar graph. It is just like a continuous connected graph. Using the various plotting techniques in matplotlib, we can definitely make two histograms almost same. Okay, so let me now elaborate a bit more about the stuff. See, in both the programs, we are using matplotlib to show the stuff. Okay, the difference, main difference between these two programs is that how we are computing the histogram. I mean, what library we are using to compute the histogram. Here we are using matplotlib to compute the histogram, and here we are using NumPy to compute the histogram. So the same way we can even compute the histogram for color images. So let us try doing that. Sorry, let us save this program first and then modify it. NumPy histogram, let's say color. So it will be something like 1. And we have already created a program using matplotlib for color histogram. we'll use the same program so that we really don't have to write the code again. So this is how we are separating the color channels. And finally, while computing the histogram, we will just say this should be 2x2, or we will not display this image, original image, altogether in order to avoid the hassle of arranging the stuff. Okay, so this is 1, 3, or let's say 3, 1, and it should be R, and let's say red histogram. And similarly, we can just say green and blue histograms. This is for green and this is for blue. So we need to make the appropriate changes. Green, and let's make it GREN, and blue BLUE. Okay, so this is the histogram for a color image. So we are basically reading the same image, but we are reading it in color mode. And when we execute it, yes, so this is red, green, and blue. What is wrong with this? I guess we made a mistake. Yeah, we are displaying it on all on the same screen. So let's make it 3, 1, 3, 2, and 3, 3, 1, 3. Yeah, now it will look more interesting. Yes, so this is red, green, and blue. We can even modify the colors that it is using to display it in a proper way. So let's modify the colors, actually the lines which represent the color, and let's not limit it to the 3000 ylim. Let's delete this ylim stuff. Xlim should be fine. Ylim should not be 3000 for this. So for giving it colors, we can just say color equal to, we can just add another parameter, add another argument to this, color equal to R. Color equal to R. Similarly, we can just say color equal to green, and color equal to blue. Yes, so this is the red histogram, this is the green histogram, and this is the blue histogram. So this is how we can compute the histogram for various channels. And in case you are not really convinced, like if it is the same histogram, we can just open the same program for which we did using matplotlib, and let's see its output. Yeah, and the output is same, correct? The only thing is that all of them are colored with the same color in matplotlib, and in numpy we are using distinct colors. We are using the relevant colors to color the line which represents the histogram. So this is how we can calculate the histograms for black and white as well as grayscale and color images using numpy, and then we can use matplotlib to display the histograms. So these are till now we have learned how to calculate the histogram using matplotlib. Now in this video we learned how to use numpy to calculate the histogram. So in the next video tutorial we are going to have a look at how to calculate the histogram using OpenCV's calchist function. I hope you liked this video tutorial. Thanks a lot. Let me know your thoughts and suggestions in the comment section. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. I will see you next time.